Indonesian knows that its strategic importance in the Southeast Asia region is increasing. Along with the increasing tensions in the region, the Indonesian archipelago has become a kind of shield between the Pacific and Indian Oceans. This makes it a strong dividing state between the two major regions of the world. All the superpowers are now aware that Indonesia is in a strategic position and may intend to forge a relationship and invest heavily in its development. Meanwhile, Indonesia's military strength has also increased significantly. Having dealt with insurgency attempts frequently, Indonesia has the most effective special unit forces in the world. In addition, the Indonesian government also has jets, and increasing the number of its navy to 200 ships, Indonesia will have a strong foundation to become a great and strong country in the future. The certainty that Indonesia will bring advanced fighter jets, such as the F-15 next to the Dassault Rafale, is increasingly becoming a reality. After previously Minister of Defense Prabowo Subianto in 2020 explored the acquisition of the main weaponry system tools to various countries, including US and French fighter jets. The Air Force Chief of Staff, Marshal Fajar Prasetyo, said, "The Indonesian Air Force from this year to 2024 will soon realize the acquisition of various main tools of modern weapon systems, two of which are multirole combat aircraft, the F-15EX and the Dassault Rafale. From this year to 2024, Indonesia will gradually acquire the main tools of the modern weapon system in stages. Some of the main tools of defense weaponry are multirole combat aircraft F-15EX and Dassault Rafale, radar X-4, airborne early warning capable aircraft, tankers namely multi-role tanker transport, C-130J transport aircraft, UCAV capable of mail, and various other defense equipment. This modern variant of the F-15 also includes fly-by-wire flight controls, a new digital cockpit, modern AESA radar and ADCP-II, and is claimed to operate with the world's fastest mission computer. The F-15EX features the Eagle passive, active warning electronic warfare system, and the survivability system to increase mission effectiveness and survivability for the operator. Boeing is also promoting the advanced radar and sensors of the F-15EX fighter jet, which features an integrated electronic warfare suite to provide the full spectrum of protection while enabling dominant engagement of new and emerging threats. Still from the Boeing website, the F-15EX is claimed to feature a 21st century cockpit, providing real-time access to battlefield information and enhancing pilots' understanding of the environment, accelerating decision-making in combat. Finally, Boeing said the F-15EX features an open mission system architecture to enable fast digital technology insertion. As previously reported, the Indonesian Air Force plans to acquire two types of advanced combat aircraft in the near future, namely the Rafale, F-3R or even F-4, made by Dassault, France, and the F-15EX Advanced Eagle made by Boeing, United States. Not only Indonesian media, foreign media also reported about it, including Air Force Magazine, which is the media released by the Air Force Association, AFA. For the record, AFA itself is an organization that stands outside the United States Air Force, USAF, but aims to educate the public about the important role of aerospace forces in defense, advocate for strong American national defense, and force and support the USAF, as well as the USAF family. Interestingly, in the last paragraph of Air Force Magazine's news regarding the possibility of Indonesia buying the F-15EX, it was stated that there was a component which the US did not seem to be releasing to Indonesia, namely a pause. In other words, even if America allowed Indonesia to buy Boeing's most advanced fighter jet at this time, the APAS equipment would likely not be included, or Boeing could not sell it to Indonesia. APAS, or Eagle Passive Active Warning Survivability System, is a digital early warning device for threats to the F-15, either radar or missile locks, in various ranges of the electromagnetic spectrum, both radar and infrared. The AESA is able to store electromagnetic spectrum data, which is directed at the F-15, then identify incoming threats, analyze them, prioritize which threats are the most dangerous, and help pilots determine which weapon, carried by the F-15, is most appropriate to neutralize these threats. Because of its sophistication, the AESA, touted as the only device which allows the United States to knock out advanced long-range air defense missiles, such as the Russian MADES 400 Triumph, beyond attack with a fleet of stealth fighter jets. Even though it invited questions from some parties, the actual position of America in this matter, if it was true that it did not allow AESA exports to Indonesia, was predictable. Especially if we carefully read a paragraph in the DSCA, Defense Security Cooperation Agency, release every time there is an American arms sale to another country. The paragraph that is always present in each of the DSCA releases is as if it were a line of repeated sentences, so that after all this time, the unsympathetic reader can ignore it. The sentence reads, "The proposed sale of this equipment and support will not alter the basic military balance in the region." In other words, in selling its homemade defense equipment, America always takes into account geopolitical factors and the balance of military power in the region concerned. In the case of the F-15EX for Indonesia, again, if America does permit the sale, then America, of course, will take into account the balance of military power that follows. For example, the balance of power with Australia, Malaysia and Singapore, which are the closest neighbors to Indonesia. With this information, which of course still has to be further confirmed, the opportunity for the Rafale fighter jet, whose technology is out of control of the US arms export, ETAR, is actually getting stronger. But again, in the buying and selling transaction of the main weaponry system, political factors can be the final determinants. Boeing's first F-15EX took to the skies for its inaugural flight on February 2, a milestone that will allow the company to deliver the first two planes to the US Air Force by the end of March. After a couple of hours of delays due to weather, which also held up plans to conduct a first flight on February 1, Boeing test pilot Matt Fatjes took off from Lambert International Airport in St. Louis, Missouri, at approximately 1:57 p.m. EST. The flight lasted approximately 90 minutes, and the plane performed as expected, Boeing said in a news release. "Today's successful flight proves the jet's safety and readiness to join our nation's fighter fleet," Boeing Vice President and F-15 Program Manager. "Our workforce is excited to build a modern fighter aircraft for the U.S. Air Force. Our customer can feel confident in its decision to invest in this platform that is capable of incorporating the latest advanced battle management systems, sensors and weapons due to the jet's digital airframe design and open mission systems architecture." The Air Force first added the F-15EX to its fiscal 2020 budget, at the behest of the Defense Department's Cost Assessment and Program Evaluation Office, or CAPE. With the Air Force and Air National Guard's fleet of 1970s era F-15C/D jets showing signs of age, the service needed to either conduct an expensive life extension or buy new planes to replace them. But with F-35 operations and sustainment costs still financially burdensome, CAPE officials argued that buying an upgraded version of the F-15E Strike Eagle, with new features developed primarily at the cost of foreign customers like Qatar and Saudi Arabia, would be a more cost-conscious option. The Air Force placed its first order for the F-15EX in July 2020, awarding a contract for the first lot of E-jets, with a value not to exceed about $1.2 billion. The entire program has a ceiling value of $23 billion. The new jets come with a host of modern features, including Honeywell's ADCP-II mission computer, the Eagle passive, active warning, and survivability system electronic warfare system made by BY Systems, the Raytheon Technologies and /APG-82 radar, fly-by-wire flight controls, and a digital cockpit. The service expects to buy at least 144 F-15EX aircraft, but the contract includes options to allow the Air Force to purchase up to 200 jets. Congress first included funds in December to purchase 8 F-15EXs through the fiscal 2020 spending bill, and lawmakers approved spending $1.2 billion to buy 12 F-15EXs in fiscal 2021. According to the Air Force's FY21 budget request, the service plans to buy another dozen planes in FY22, procuring 14 F-15EXs in FY23, and ramping up to 19 jets per year in both FY24 and FY25. Once delivered to the Air Force, the first two F-15EXs will go to Eglin Air Force Base, Florida, for testing, with the remaining six aircraft set to be delivered to the base in FY23.